Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy, Brett Summers, Nipsey Russell, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. How do you do? I thank you. We're a very enthusiastic bunch here we have in the studio, and I hope you at home are just as enthusiastic and as receptive as these. We thank you for joining us, and we thank you for joining us.
We thank you for joining us.
Well, that's very kind.
Thank you for thanking us.
Are you ready for whatever's going to happen?
No.
Yeah, well, it's going to happen, believe me. Let's say hello to our two players, Johanna Sartori and Joyce Nunley.
Hello, Johanna!
Joyce is a current champ. She's won $600, one game, and she's happy about that, aren't you, Joyce?
Very.
Yes. What do you call these little things that hang down there?
Ears.
Hanging down droppings.
Hanging down bits of hair. That looks very nice.
Thank you.
All right. And this lady is challenging her, and we finished part of the game. We finished 1.5 rounds, and we got to go to the second half of the final round for you. You must match 4 celebrities to stay in the game. 5, however, we'll win another game for you, and we'll find out if that happens right after we find out about this. All right, here we go, folks.
Yes.
We have a little fun and games going on here while those messages are passed along to you. As I said, it's 5-1 in favor of our challenger. We're going to finish our second and final round here with this assignment for Joyce Nunley, who must match 4 celebrities to stay in the game. Everyone participates except Ann Elder. Poor Fred. While trying to get something out of the blank, he fell in. Poor Fred. While trying to get something out of the blank, he fell in. Don't think too hard, Nipsey. It'll be a strain, and then...
And you'll end up like me, Nipsey, and you'll be sorry.
All right, now they're all set over there. So, Joyce, which answer do you think would match these celebrities? Poor Fred, while trying to get something out of the blank, he fell in.
Out of the toilet.
That's a very graphic, direct, straightforward answer, isn't it?
She's a teacher.
Yeah, okay. All right, Bert, what did you say?
Well, first of all, I'd like to know what Fred was trying to get out of there. I said freezer.
You fell in the freezer.
Yes.
All right, you must match all the way across here to stay in the game. Fred?
Do you know that a toilet never occurred to me? I said larder.
Out of the larder. So, Johanna is our winner. Congratulations to you. Thank you for coming around, please.
Well, don't feel bad, Joyce.
There's one up there. And there's a well there. You had it, too.
Well.
We had a couple of wells and a couple of biffies over there. All right. So you stand by for just a moment while we say goodbye to Joyce Nunley, who's won $600. Together with our thanks for being here, you're a marvelous lady and a good player. Goodbye, Joyce. You got fans out there?
Yes.
Who's out there?
My mom.
Where's your mom?
She's right there.
In the second,
yeah,
where?
And her boyfriend, and my sister and her husband, right in the front, the 4, and the black, and the white,
yes,
and the blue, right there.
Would your mother hold up her hand, please? Oh, there's your mother, right there. Okay.
Now, would you hold up your other hand, please?
Would you hold up your...
This is a stick-up.
All right, you're ready to have a go at it, are you? You know what happens now?
Yeah.
All right, you're going to have a try at the real big money. You've got $100 for winning that game, now a chance at $5,000 here in the Super Match. We polled a recent studio audience, Johanna, and we got their best response to this. Flat blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, if you can match it.
Okay.
And the second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Which 3 celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Marianne.
Marianne, flat...
I'll go along with our audience, flat tire.
Flat tire. Okay, there's one answer for you.
Bert.
Bert Convy, flat...
Flat foot.
Flat foot.
A flat foot.
Flat foot.
Flat foot, yes.
Okay, there's two.
Nipsey.
Well, I'll take the other extreme. Flathead.
Flathead. Flathead, he said. Okay. You got flat tire, flat foot, and flathead. You may choose one of those as the answer you think will be the most valuable to you, or give us one of your own.
I'll take flat tire.
Flat tire. That's it. That's Mary Ann's answer. That's the one we're looking for. So let's begin by revealing the $100 response. Flat Chester.
Yeah, here it is.
How could they even think that? I'm on the again. Be embarrassed. Oh, I'm sorry. That's all right. Don't worry about it now. Money will be very comforting to you. Flat tire is what we're looking for. May we see the $250 response. Flat top. Who said that? No one said that. Well, you said flat head, but that's not flat top exactly. Here's your third and last chance, Johanna, and I hope it's there for your sake. Here is the $500 response. So you've got that $500. That's yours. That means you're up to $600 at this moment. More important than that, it means you play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. To collect, you have to have an exact match with one of our celebrities. Which one do you choose?
Mary Ann.
Mary Ann, you're going to have another go at it. Get ready to write. Aww. You face me, Johanna. Here is the question that's worth $5,000 to you. Blank strip. STRIP. Blank strip. Don't think too long, Mary Ann. Trust your first instinct. Blank strip. Okay, she's finished now. Now, Johanna, we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Blank strip.
Sunset strip.
Sunset strip. I guess the Californians would applaud that answer. And Mary Ann, now for $5,000, may we see your answer?
She's going to hate herself.
I already do. I was just so dumb. Flat strip.
Oh. All right, well, you drew a blank on it. That happens sometimes. Sunset strip.
That is the most logical.
Yeah, I guess in this part of the country
here?
It is.
I don't know.
If you were in Secaucus, New Jersey, would be a rotten answer, Sunset Strip. But here we are in Los Angeles. You're our winner. You've got $600. You're going to meet another player, and here comes that player now. Let's say hello to Rita Rossler.
Hi, Rita. Thank you, Mary Ann. You made me look like a genius.
You ladies know each other, and we welcome you, Rita, and we ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm married, a mother, two beautiful little kids.
How old are your kids?
6 and 3, and oh, are they little tears. And in my leisure, we love camping and dirt bike riding.
Dirt bike riding?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, you know how we play? You and this lady are going to be answering questions, trying to match these six kooks over here.
Okay.
And the one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner and has a chance to go on to the super match where you can win $5,000. Our challenger makes the selection, so if you would, Rita, please.
I think I'll take B.
We leave it up to you because some contestants find some questions harder than others.
Yeah.
Everyone plays.
All right.
You notice that.
Toulouse-Lautrec said... I wish I was taller. I'm really tired of looking at people's blanks. Toulouse-Lautrec, you remember him?
Yes, I certainly do.
Will the real Gene Rayburn please stand up?
I'm really tired of looking at people's blanks, is what old Toulouse said. Down there at the, what was the name of that place he hung out at?
Moulin Rouge.
The Moulin Rouge, yes.
I'm still on Sunset Strip.
Yes. Brett, are you having...
Yeah, I was just trying to figure out how tall he was.
Figure it out and do it.
Oh, darn it, I can't spell that.
I don't care about spelling. Spelling doesn't mean a thing. All right, how do you handle this, Rita? Toulouse-Lautrec said, I wish I was taller. I'm really tired of looking at people's blanks.
At their navels.
at their navels there. She said navels, folks. Well, what did you say,
I wish you'd get up, that's what I said. I said belly buttons, which
belly
I believe
buttons
is the
and
same.
Navels a match, very good. All right, Brett.
I said whatever that spells.
Thighs.
Thighs.
Well, that's spelled correctly.
Well, if you come about there.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. Nipsey.
Ça va dire cuisse en français, the navel.
Navels. Well, there's two for you. Okay. Mary Ann?
Well, I thought he was much shorter. He was looking at their knees.
Oh, he wasn't that short, no.
I'm surprised at you.
What do you say, art lover?
But you see, I must tell you that being that small, you can only take very small steps, so usually everybody passes you, and all you see is Al behind you. Well, if he was the other way around, the navel would be there. Could I get a half
never
a
mind,
point?
You just said
no, no, you can't. No match there at all.
Well, what about
navel?
A
is the answer we're looking for. What do you say, no Anne?
I'm there. Looking for a navel, but I'm going to have to settle for knees.
Knees, it is.
Here you come here.
All right. So you scored twice with that. We'll get to your question right after we get to this. So don't go away. We've got a lot more games. Now let's carry on here with this game.
No,
2-0 the score. She's completed her half of round one, and we'll complete your half of it now and see how you do. Arthur couldn't get into the army because he was blank. Arthur couldn't get into the army because he was blank. Arthur couldn't get into the army, Nipsey, because he was blank. That's nothing to this, is it? Have you ever been in the army?
I have.
You have?
I have failed the physical, had stomach trouble. No you, guts.
No guts.
I said it first. I'm sorry to say.
Everybody over there is ready, except Nipsey. Oh, no. All right. Now, Johanna, how do you respond to this? Arthur couldn't get into the army because he was...
too young.
Too young, she says. A very logical answer. Bert, what's your answer?
Logical if you're gay, is what I
thought. She's too gay. Okay. Couldn't stand all that sunshine and happiness. Brett, what do you say?
Well, I went that route, but not quite that far. He was a dancer.
He was a dancer. Okay. What do you...
That's his way to the top.
He was blind drunk, is what Nipsey says. Blind drunk is your answer, Nipsey. You wrote that, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
No match yet.
Because I know a lot of gay people in the army.
Yeah. Too young is her answer, and you couldn't get in the army either with that cough, Brett.
She is testing for Camille.
I have an ambulance
Mary Ann?
Outside.
He was too young, but he was also flat-footed.
Flat-footed. Flat-footed. All right, that'll keep you out. Richard, what's your excuse?
Well, he was in the army for a short time until he uttered those words, "Isn't this war a scream?" Gay, I'm sure. I asked him to leave.
Yes, of course. And
he's the guy who wanted the uniforms to be out of paisley, as
right.
I recall. Yes, he was sissy-ish.
That's it. So, too young didn't work for you, and now we'll go to round two. At the end of round one, our challenger's ahead 2-0, and we ask you to make a selection.
I'll stay with B.
B is what she wants. Now, last time out, you matched Nipsey and Bert, so the two of you do not participate. The others will.
I
want to
play.
Walter told the mermaid she had the prettiest blank he had ever seen. Walter told the mermaid she had the prettiest blank he had ever seen. All ready. All right. The die is cast. Now we call on Rita for her response.
The die is cast.
Beautiful. I just made that
who
up.
Cast
that? What?
The prettiest tail he'd ever seen.
Prettiest tail he'd ever seen. Your die is cast, so just... Rhett, what do you say? Tail is her answer.
Mine starts with a T. Tail.
Tail.
Made you nervous, didn't I?
You sure did. And we're going to skip Nipsey because he matched last time and go right down here to Mary Ann Mulberry.
A beautiful tail.
There you go. That was a very good answer. How about you, sir?
Is story the same thing as tail?
Tail.
Tail it is. Another match for you. And what have we got from Ann Elder?
Did you actually say the die is cast?
Yeah, I said the die is cast.
I think your cast is dead.
Yes,
I said a tail.
Okay. So you're up to six. Now, you know when we come back from this commercial that you've got to match all the way across to achieve a tie and stay in the game. So we'll do this commercial, and then we'll come right back. So here we go. This lady has got to match every celebrity up there to stay in the game. Listen carefully to the question. Think before you give your response. Here we go. Elmer the elephant said, "I'm a little concerned about my honeymoon. You see, I'm marrying a blank." Elmer the elephant. He said, "I'm a little concerned about my honeymoon. You see, I'm marrying a blank." Bert's first one finished. He doesn't fiddle around. He just, thought came in his head, bing, he put it right down there.
Did he?
Yep.
That's because the thought didn't come into his head.
Get him, put one down for me.
No, no, no. Everybody does his own thing here.
Only one thought to add.
All right, now we're all set. Elmer the elephant said, "I'm a little concerned about my honeymoon. You see, I'm marrying a..."
Mouse.
She says mouse. Anybody in the audience seems to like mouse. If we get one answer that does not say mouse, the game is over. Bert, we begin with you.
Well, I think I'll start the ball rolling then with mouse.
Okay. We got one. Brett?
I remembered a joke about an elephant and a monkey. Mm-hmm. And it seemed that they got married.
Really? So that means the game is over and Rita's our champion. Congratulate you. Would you come down? Mouse, what do you have, a mouse? Okay, would you stand? Sorry. Congratulations to you. You've got $100 for winning the game. And now we've got to say goodbye to Johanna. $600 will be sent to her in due course. We thank you for being on Match Game 73. Goodbye, Johanna.
What's that?
This is the exciting part.
I thought the other part was pretty exciting, too.
Well, my husband wants the money.
Where is he?
He wants a new motorcycle.
Your husband wants a new motorcycle?
Yes.
And you're going to give him this money to get a new motorcycle?
Oh, no. Uh-huh. What do you think about it?
See. Well, good luck to you. You know how this goes. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank flake. Blank flake. No help. We thank you for your enthusiasm, but you may be hollering out a rotten answer and mislead this young lady astray here. The answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if you can match it. Second most frequent response, 250, and third, 100. Now, choose three celebrities one at a time, get their answers.
Richard?
Cornflake.
Cornflake, you said. Okay. Number two?
Marianne.
Snowflake.
Got two good ones there. One more?
Nipsey.
I thought that was all. Wheat flake.
Wheat flake.
Okay.
Wheat flake.
Wheat flake.
The dice
guy. I'm going to flake wheat.
All right. You've got cornflake, snowflake, and wheat flake. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you
want
to do?
You eat what you want for breakfast, I'll eat what I want.
Okay.
Snowflake.
Snowflake, you think it is?
Snowflake is right. Yeah.
That's the one we are looking for. May we see the $100 response. Soap flake.
Oh, nice, I see nobody thought of that.
That's right.
You didn't have breakfast.
I'll personally pay you $1,000 if wheat flake comes up next year. We're looking for snowflake.
Please let it come up.
Snowflake is what we're looking for. This is like rolling dice. Here we go. May we see the $250 response. Cornflake.
The next
Richard.
Is wheat flake.
No, it isn't. Little side bet here. Here it is. Snowflake is what we're looking for. The $500 response.
Yes, sir.
Snowflake. Congratulations. Okay, you're up to $600. You got the $500. That means you're now playing for 10 times that amount or $5,000. But to collect, you've got to match one person over there on a head-to-head basis, and it must be an exact match. Whom do you choose?
I'm going to stick with Marianne.
Oh, no.
Going to stick with Marianne.
No.
Get ready to write, Marianne. You face
oh,
me.
Golly.
If you would, please. Rita, here is the $5,000 question.
Oh.
Are you ready, Marianne?
Oh, no, but let's go.
Okay.
She didn't eat her wheat flakes as well.
Here it is.
fairy blank. F-A-I-R-Y blank.
Why don't you leave the gay people alone?
Marianne has finished. Rita, now you give us your response to this. Fairy
princess.
Oh, no!
I think the audience has suddenly turned on you, including your husband out there. Well, anyway, that's your answer. Fairy princess. Marianne, for $5,000, may we see your answer? Marianne?
I said fairy tale.
Fairy tale. Well, apparently that's the answer the audience thought was the correct one. You've still got $600. You're going to play another game, but first we've got this message we're going to pass along. When we come back next time, Rita will meet another challenger and play another game of Match Game 73. We thank you for being with us. You were all just beautiful. You're beautiful people.
Thank you.
And I thank you very much. We've had a lot of fun with you. Next time we get together, we will have this galaxy of stars.
Pat Harrington, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Clues, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Team Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are a wearing air freshenizer. It fills the room with a fresh, clean scent and helps make the air you breathe a little nicer without mist or vapor from wearing. And a supply of fantastic spray cleaner. Clean without bucket or mess, just spray, wipe, dirt storm. Fantastic from Texas. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.